will be kicking off. It is, of course, the South African side, Bidvest, that will be hosted by Atletico Madrid. It is a big one because any team that wins it, it will be for their very first time at the Nike Training Football Center in Pimville, Soweto. And as you know, that the World of Champions will be bringing you all that action. And all the action, of course, you will be able to interact with us at SuperSport TV, hashtag SS Football. To help me build up, I've got Farouk Khan. A very intriguing final between the two sides. From judging from yesterday's game of play, what would you say about what we can expect today?
Well, there's very little to choose between the two. I think both teams have shown they have what it takes, and they got to the final itself. Obviously, Bidvest will come in as underdogs, looking at the pedigree of Atletico Madrid. But in saying that, they've shown that no opponent is too big for them.
Definitely. Now let's take a look at how these teams have made it through to the finals. As we know that yesterday they played, of course, against Bidvest, then played and won 2-1, and Atletico Madrid won and 1-0. And these are some of the goals. It's been brilliant how we've seen the attack of Atletico Madrid as well as its defense.
Yeah, well, it's all about being well organized without the ball and being very efficient and forward-thinking in your attack. Mm. And that's clearly what we've seen with the likes of Madrid. Even with Tijuana, I mean, what an intriguing game it was.
Definitely, and with no goals conceded as well for Atletico Madrid.
That's important. Keep a clean sheet and you're in with a chance.
No goals conceded for Atletico Madrid. Does that then say that they are the more better team today to walk away victorious against Bidvest? But we don't know. But let's take a look at how they made it through all their matches they've won. Although it's been very slight chances. I mean, you take a look at their last minute goal against Aces as well as Orlando Pirates.
There's been no easy games. I think everybody had to really fight, with the exception of the Mozambican game. I think all the other games were closely contested.
Definitely, but when you take a look at Bidvest, their games were on fire, especially when you take a look at the one that they played yesterday when they won 2-1, and missing that last goal there, that could have made it 3-1.
No, they could have. They've been grinding certain results, but they scored when it mattered most. They are ecstatic. The first time a South African team is able to carry that trophy and give South Africans that joy to say we are now at the stage where we can win these tournaments.
And also for Bidvest, their first time in the final, they're playing the Spanish La Liga Giants. Do you think that will have some confidence? Will that be a confidence booster? Will that affect them?
I think they're going to go into this final with confidence. It's the first time they've reached it, and they're going to give their best.
Definitely, they have to do that to ensure that they put South Africa on the map. Should they win, it will be the very first time that a South African team takes the championship title. But let's take a look at how they have done their first game against the Italian side, Torino FC. They lost that one, but the biggest one was against Shandong Luneng when they won their 3-1.
Yeah, no, Shandong showed that they also have a lot of quality, a lot of tactical awareness, good technique. But at the end, Bidvest determination really came to the fore.
Definitely. It's all about the pride of the countries. Which country will walk away victorious? Will it be Spain? Will it be Bidvest? We'll have to wait for the 60 minutes to see. But up next, though, we have, of course, Temba Boy, as well as Grant Visit and Farouk Khan in the commentary, who will take us through that match.
It's the big one, the one we've all been waiting for. It's the final of future champs, Gauteng. Well, Atletico de Madrid have stormed South African shores like the Spanish Armada, and now only Bidvest stand between them and the coveted trophy. All others who have opposed them have been swept aside. But for those of you who know your history, the powerful Spanish fleet of 1588 left foreign shores thoroughly defeated. Perhaps that little window into the past doesn't hold much credence here, but whilst Roy Blancos believe that they are setting sail with the trophy in their possession, the Clever Boys are out to sink their ambitions and become the first ever local team to take top honours. They certainly will have the South African support behind them. And man, oh man, what support it will be, because the Nike Center here in Soweto has ever so slowly filled up for this big one, this hotly, hotly anticipated final between two sides who I think very few can argue don't deserve to be here. They are the two best sides in the competition by a country mile, some might say. And in fact, whilst on paper it may look like Bidvest versus South Africa are underdogs to Atletico de Madrid, They've produced results that are, in many cases, more impressive than their Spanish counterparts. The applause from everyone in the stadium for these two sides. Gilmore Coupe, featured momentarily on screen, will lead his young charges into battle. It is poised to be an absolute humdinger as the take a chance now to meet the dignitaries. Their routes to the final have been, well, for both teams, it's been rather easy going. This will be their first real toughest test. Both won by a one goal margin last time out. Atletico Madrid 1-0 against Orlando Pirates. Yakin scoring his
answer is yes. That the Zwets have been efficient through the boot of Shunga Tutura. They've found those margins to win. Well, the man from Athletic Madrid haven't conceded the tournament in the march to the final. So yes, two teams that are deserving to be in this final.
Well, the most resolute of defenses coming up against the most vaunted of attacks in this competition. Atletico de Madrid have had to make a change in the midfield. Mikel is out with a knee ligament injury. He's replaced by Gasco. Commonly you see that man occupying the role of a center back. He'll be providing cover just in front of the defense one suspects. The coach keeping a watchful eye over them. De La Moreno has remained cool and calm for most of this competition. Hasn't really needed to actually amp things up at all because his team have performed ever so well. Given Mabasa, the referee in charge today, he's been given the honor of taking charge of this final. As we take a brief look at how Bidvest fits line up, the captain Gilmore Coupe occupies a position in the heart of defense. He'll be key, as will Shungo Dotiro, the focal point of the Bidvest Wits attack. It's a young team, a young talented team looking to do the business against the Spaniards today, as Dylan Shepherd, well, he's taken to coaching after a long and successful career, still on the books of Bidvest Wits as a player even, and charged with helping these youngsters step up to the next level. And my oh my, what a job he's doing at the moment.
Oh God, what a way, what a start for his managerial career, winning this prestigious Future Champs Gauteng tournament, creating his own piece of history as the Wits boys just getting last little bit of motivation. Remember, no South African team has ever won this competition.
Well, history would be created with a result that went either way. Of course, Atletico de Madrid, the first Spanish team to ever compete, so if they were to win, that honor of being the first team from Spain would, of course, go to them, whilst Bidvest Wits could become the first ever local side to take the crown. And many may suspect that they will be able to, on the evidence that has been provided in the four games prior to this. They've looked deadly, maybe got off to a little bit of a shaky start against Torino, and then since then, devastating an attack,
and a team that is a unit. They know how to work for each other as well. They can find that added bit of something, Grant, when the going gets tough. They say the tough get going, and through Shungo Dutiro, my oh my, they've been efficient have a deadly finisher who can change the game with the flick of a switch, Grant.
He certainly can. We've spoken time and time again about the fact that he may not even have a sniff for the first half. And once he gets an opportunity, more likely than not, he's going to put it into the back of the net. Wonderful finisher, Oscar. The clever flick. But Vespits clear their line. Out to Itzen Khumalo. And up very quickly in search of Dlamini. Now the Cuban, Carlos. Put under a little bit of pressure and Alex clears. It's not the best. Alex is a keeper that we haven't really seen be tested as Yakin drives forward. Still going. Sets up Andy. Scored two goals in the opening game of the competition. And a panicky moment at the back for Bidvest Spitz early on.
Oh, there was scrambling there with a man from Wirtz. Shows you how good an understanding this Athletic Madrid team have. The likes of Andy Yakin. That name Andy, look out for the number 11. He's a wizard, I tell you. But let's give her credit though to the Wirtz defense as well. They did manage to eventually scramble, not concede.
Chance now for Atto, who plays in Fede. Powerful 16-year-old. Can't beat Givemore Coupe. Himself a 16-year-old player, one that we are very accustomed to seeing on our television screens on your World of Champions. Was a fixture in the Bidvest Wirtz multi-choice Disky Challenge team. Coming forward once again, early goal, Yakin scores for the second game in a row, and Atletico Madrid are ahead very early on, not the start that Bidvest Wirtz would have wanted.
Oh God, problems for Dylan Shepherd and co, an early headache as the look forward, Rodrigo Gomez looks forward, and they get a good ball in it, nobody picking up the onrushing players. Is that man Andy again? Yakin, lovely little finish to just open up his body, side-footed. I think that's the second of the competition.
It is most certainly his second. It's a sublime finish, it really is. Has got going a little late. Only scored in their fourth game of the competition. It's a dry spell for him in the previous three games. But he's making amends for his lack of efficacy up front early in the competition.
Grant, it's not about how you start, it's how you finish. And then the biggest, I think, problem for Bidvest Wirtz is Athletic Madrid are a tough nut to crack. Once they go forward, they don't concede much.
Good work by Edson Khumalo, and then fouled by Fede. Let's keep a close eye on this battle as Federico offers him a helping hand up. Not often that Federico comes up against a player that is stronger than him. It remains to be seen whether Edson Khumalo will continue to beat him for pace and strength. Yesterday came up against James Munyane of Orlando Pirates and really struggled, actually. Free kick to come. Referee a little bit unhappy with events transpiring in the box. All fingers seem to be pointed towards Givemore Coupe. He's disinterested.
I can tell you now, given my boss, I was saying, Givemore Coupe, right, the captain there.
Whipped in low. Fede doesn't deal with it. Almost comes out to Dotiro. Now this is trouble. Cleared away hurriedly.
Grant, as we see that ball go out. An interesting one I was noticing with the set piece, as all sort of shenanigans were going on, as Given Mabasa tried to calm things down. The number nine for Wirtz, Shungu Dutiro, was standing in an offside position. It was an interesting one, looking perhaps just sneak back in. We told you the man is nifty, full of guard, that young man. But thus far, there's only one number nine who's been top man in this game. And that's the man, Yakin.
Both number nine scored last time out. Both would have been hoping to get on the score sheet again. Yakin no longer has to hope for his first goal. He's got it. Now Oscar delivers in to the back post. Andy will probably look to cut this back. Draws a man. Still he has it. Comes out to Luque. Now Andy. Danger for the clever boys. And eventually closed down nicely by Keenan Phillips.
Give credit to Keenan Phillips. He's really grown strength to strength in this tournament. As the right back. Did well to stay tight with Andy.
Now Rodri with the ball in. Cleared once again by Keenan Phillips from Cape Town. Nicely done by Shungu Totero. It was a good covering work. And once he had turned his man, he was just held up slightly. Fede gives himself a little bit too much to do.
Fede, an interesting character, colorful character. I've been following him, and man, full of passion. Just a quick one, Grant, Shungu Didira, that little turn. That in a nutshell and a microcosm is Shungu Didira for me. You just get a ball and quickly turn you, and then next thing you know, in it is.
He's already thinking about his next move before the ball even comes to him. Nicely done, nipped in from behind. September. Man who hails from PE. Now Montero will just usher this, or shepherd it rather, back to his keeper Alex, who's not interested in picking it up. 17-year-old glove man plays it out quickly to Carlos, who finds Fede. Fede bringing down Muzikanyi, who then seemed to take umbrage with the way in which he had been felled and almost seemed to swing his legs at the Atletico man who hails from Equatorial Guinea. Kanye to deliver. The back post, and it's over Cooper's head. Speaking of balls going over Cooper's head, Bidvest fits. We're ever so close to bowing out of this competition, or rather losing their spot in the final. Poor defending from usually very consummate defender. Shot comes in from Edson Kumalo after a mistake, an uncharacteristic mistake from the Atletico backline. Speaking of uncharacteristic mistakes, going back to Coupe, he would have been very pleased that Bidvest Fitz were able to come back into the game and eventually win it 2-1.
Grant, I think in that replay you get to see the pressure that Fitz put on to ensure that Athletic Madrid players don't have an easy pass out, and that was a result of the pressure they put on.
Yakin fighting hard but losing out. Dotiro, here he comes. Massive pace. Tries to score, can't do it. Keeper off his line. Hurries back and manages to recover. Now the ball lifted in. Will not be met by Kanye. That is frightening, frightening pace from the clever boys front man, Dotiro.
Oh, let's give props as well to that lovely weighted pass. Didn't have to break stride. Did Dotiro, but wow, I thought he had actually was going to punish that one, Grant. As we've often seen similar finishes from him. Wow, big miss.
Flicked on by Dotiro. Now Andy doing a little bit of defensive work. Chad van Heerden plays it into the midfield. Keenan Phillips tries to find a route upfield. Not able to do so. He's one of the young men that will compete at the Bay Hill tournament, the prestigious Bay Hill tournament in Cape Town, one of many in this team that will do so. The likes of Dotero, Coupe, September, all joining him. It's an under 19 tournament, so it just shows the faith that they have in these youngsters as Oscar drives forward. Skill on the sidelines. Now Andy, likewise, utilizing some fancy footwork. Silky smooth from the Spaniards right now.
Grant those two, number 10 and number 11 for Athletic Madrid. Oscar and Andy have been doing this to so many teams this tournament.
Totero chasing there. They can't afford such a lack back passes. Now trouble for Coupe. Drags down. Still alive for Joaquin. And the keeper holds it. So advantage played excellently by Given Mabasa. It was a terrible foul outside the box. Given Coupe on Atto, who picks up the ball now. Not the best game so far for Coupe, must be said. And he's a very, very good and promising defender. Here he is clearing out.
Not sure what he was trying to do. They allowed the ball to bounce. Didn't know what was behind him. Grant, and as a result, was swamped very quickly. I thought there was going to be the second of the game, but Joaquin couldn't sort out his feet in time.
Well, 16-year-old keeper Meyer does ever so well. Now, Coupe switches play. Well taken on the chest and then dragged back by September. Well, that is a Bidvest free kick. Looked like September was the aggressor on that occasion. Kanye goes down, nothing doing. Goal kick for Atletico Madrid. Andy, great flick. Nicely done by Phillips to read that one. Montero. The crowd reaction suggests that he handled that. Dotero lays it back and then makes his way into the box to provide an option, but the move breaks down. It's been quite end to end here as we go forward, Timber. Dotero, nice flick.
End to end, both teams really want this badly, Grant.
Really do, flying forward, and then the foul committed by Gasco.
An indication, Grant, of how badly these two teams want it. Look how far the left back for Vets had pushed up. Garabo Mudibedi was eventually just brought down there.
Mudibedi, another one very highly rated amongst the youth ranks here, will also be going to the Bay Hill tournament in Cape Town. Only 16 years of age. A foul count racking up for Atletico Madrid. Yesterday against Orlando Pirates, we saw that Atletico Madrid were guilty of committing far more fouls than their South African opponents. The same trend continues today. Not afraid to put a foot in order to stop a prospective attack. The two wingers for Bidvest are interested in this one. Edson Kamalo, Muzi Kanye. It is Kanye into the wall. And hacks clear. If I have to come up with a stat off the top of my head, I would say that about 60 to 70% of all direct free kicks have flown into the wall during this competition. We're yet to see one actually be scored.
Mm. An interesting one there, Grant. A lot of the teams have been disappointing when it comes to set pieces. Also an interesting one, I was looking at that wall, the likes of Fede and Andy, quite small men, and for me, if I was taking that set piece, I would have lined it, the ball, to sort of their angle, just try to flip it over their heads.
Ball goes in, it's poor. Nicely done by Phillips. presents another opportunity. This time Dlamini losing out, and again Phillips wins it in the air. In the last 10 minutes of the game, it's been quite evenly matched. Bidvest Wits having a little more of the possession. Doesn't surprise me though, they are a goal down. Alex launches it upfield. Probably the best kicking ability of any of the keepers at this tournament. And to be honest, that's all we've really seen from him.
Grant, I was about to say that I've been looking at the keeper, Alex. I think that was the first instance where he put his foot through the ball. The most instances he opts to just lay it off to the next man. Clear philosophy from the man from Athletic Madrid.
And it comes back to him from Phillips. Not many midfielders or attacking players availing themselves. And that's a very loose ball. The touch is poor from Oscar. Now, Dotiro. Again, poor passing. Poor passing from both sides. Rodri trying to locate Yakin. It'll just run harmlessly out.
Granvitz don't want to be putting pressure onto themselves unnecessarily, lose possession. And the likes of Yakin and Andy have already shown that they will punish you off your mistakes. Mind you, they don't need mistakes. You're doing them favors now if you give them easy possession.
Meyer upfield. The intention was to find Dotero.
Grand last couple of minutes, the Vets boys have just lost a bit of confidence and haven't been able to play through the likes of Geneva in September, Sydney Rowan. Perhaps as a consequence of that missed chance from Dotero Shungu.
They came back against European opposition in their first game of the tournament. They'll need a repeat performance here. Of course, one goal would be enough to force penalties. They're yet to see penalties in this competition.
Let's give it up for those Chiefs fans who've actually added one more man to the choir by the looks of it. They've been absolutely singing their little heart out since the morning.
It's a wonderful energy from them. I honestly don't know how they've kept it up for this entire day.
Energy drinks, that's what we feed off.
Atto takes the ball in field. Finds Oscar. Phillips can't clear. Now Andy, great little pirouette inside the box. Kamalo mugged from behind. Now Dlamini comes away with it.
I think the referee there, Mr. Mabaso, might have missed something that I think Andy was being pulled back. As you see a foul on Yakin.
This one he calls correctly. Yakin brought to ground. Modabedi had to make the challenge, otherwise Yakin would have been in all kinds of space to deliver a very measured ball with his right foot.
On the subject of referees, we've had some, can I call them soft free kicks today?
Oh, we have. Meyer comes for it. Montero, the center back, had advanced into the box. Now Dotero traps with his chest. Lays it up nicely to Edson Kumalo. Will try and locate someone in the box. Doesn't. Sputlamini was arriving. Dotero was also making his way into the box. It's disappointing. Need to utilize your opportunities. There's your fans, Temba.
Those are the fans. Yep. Uleto Chipi and Singa Chipi. Sitsi Ai Naibeta Matota. Added one or two. Called in reinforcements. Our gentlemen.
Skill. And then not a pass to match.
Quick one, whenever you say Andy, it's always the first word, skill or flair.
It really is. His first touch is always incredibly inventive. Usually flicking it over the head of an oncoming player. No one's really been able to figure him out. He's been read on one or two occasions by Phillips, but for the most part, he gets away with those fancy little flicks. Akupe. Now to Muzikani. Battling away with Fede. Fede feels like he was the one that was fouled, and now shirt pulling.
Ooh, trouble,
from
Kane. Trouble.
Real trouble here. What will the referee decide? This could really change the game. It's Gasco, the defender who's playing in midfield. Given Mabasa has a massive, massive decision to make. Gasco pulling his shirt. And then Muzikani lashes out.
Grant, I do think, though, as much as there was contact, Gasco's just milking it a bit, though. But nonetheless, as you did say, given Mabaso had a major decision to make. The moment has come and gone. He's had enough time to internalize and sort of think of the right decision. And it's going to be a yellow, Grant.
It's going to be
Gasco as well.
A yellow for Gasco.
Perhaps for putting the shirt, yes.
And
now, what color is the card for Kanye?
Well, he hasn't made his decision yet. Still taking time. He calls Kanye over. He's waiting to see what his fate will be. And it's only a yellow. Both sides remain with 11 players on the park. A nervy moment there. Muzikani was made to wait an absolute age to find out his fate. We saw Torino go down to 10 men in the fifth place playoff and managed to, well, they managed to win 2-0 of Atletico Mineiro, rather.
Lucky boy, Kanye, as you can see by the relief when he patted the referee on the back, said, thank you, Sabo.
What a bitty. A flick. Dotero was interested. Here he is again, still fighting. Chance to show his pace and can't.
Well, this young man, Shungo Dotero, so purposeful. Stocky player, quick on the turn. Always looks like he just creates something out of nothing.
And what a Betty clears. Alex distributes to Montero. That's nicely done. Just moves past the oncoming attacker. He's done it many times. He's a classy, classy defender.
Grant, there was that man, Andy, again. Mm. It's always as if the ball is glued to his feet.
He's one to watch. Absolutely. he may inspire others. Dotiro, in a very similar player in the fact that his acceleration is blistering. Of course, that's one of the attributes that Mutlambi relies on and makes him so very, very deadly. Now Dotiro with a loose touch. He's the kind of player that needs to receive the ball behind the defense, needs to time his run perfectly, and once he's past you, there's no ways that you're going to make up the ground and catch him. There's a lightning bolt. Attempted switch there by Kanyi. And then cleared away by Montero. Not what we're used to seeing from him. His boot seems to have come loose in the process.
Good man, Montero in shot. So good in possession. Was an agricultural type finish there from him. Not what we've been accustomed to seeing.
Just about ties his boot in time to get up and make sure that nothing more comes from that throw.
Mudabedi down again.
Yeah. Makes the tackle, hacks it clear.
Thought there for a second that the Vetsa player, that man, Sydney Rowan, was going to hit the deck. It's like he'd just been able to sneak the ball past opposition defender. And he had made contact from where I was sitting. But the young man remained on his feet, Grant.
Credit to him for that. Still only an under 15. Was 14 at the beginning of this year, at his birthday recently. What a talent he is. Threaded through, not accurately enough for Spoot Lamini.
That was badly misjudged there by that man, Edson Khumalo. If he actually just looked up a bit earlier, there was a man right next to him. It was an easier angle to get the ball to Spoot Lamini.
Atta tries to find Yakin. Now Yakin has been the first choice striker at this competition all the way through, but characteristically at under 17 level, he plays second fiddle to Giovanni Navarro. Now he's currently in Sweden for the under 17 Euro champs. Is their first choice man.
Hey. Nice one on that one, Grant. As you were speaking, you just
Alex with lots to do, misjudges the bounce off the back header, their back pass from Montero via his head. That was almost a terrible mistake.
That was just a simple clearance there. And that man there, Alex, nearly getting his keeper under pressure. Did well, Alex, in the end.
Good athleticism. And although it's not as consequence of a shot from the opposition, that's really the most difficult piece of goalkeeping work he's had to do the entire competition, and it's game five. Of course, he was on the bench one of the games, but still, it just shows how tight Atletico Madrid are at the back. And because of their ever so impressive defense, they've kept a clean sheet in the first half of the final. They've also managed to find the back of the net via the boot of Yakin. Atletico Madrid lead Bidvest Wits by 1-0.
Boy, oh boy, the action that we have seen has been on another level. Atletico Madrid leading by 1-0 against Bidvest Wits. Don't forget that you can be a part of the action at SuperSport TV, hashtag SS of football. After this, we take a look at the first 30 minutes, and then we will all be talking to Phakamani Mahlambi, a young boy who has made history and personifies a lot when it comes to South African football.
Bitvest Wits went behind early on. Atletico Madrid, possibly the favorites for this competition prior to it, are leading 1-0 in the final. And to be fair, they have deserved it. It was a very neat finish by Akin, the 17-year-old from Malaga, just turning it past Daniel Mayer.
Oh, granted, credit must go to the left winger, Andy. That's that piece of individual brilliance that he's often brought to the table. Yet another assist for him.
Well, Akin could hardly miss that, could he? That's how they went ahead, and then just held on to their lead for the remainder of the half, although there were a few hairy moments of their own making for Atletico de Madrid.
Well, earlier than that as well, Shungu Didiro had an opportunity, a one-on-one for a well-weighted pass. That was perhaps his second, that was more of a half chance. Alex did well in between the sticks.
Well, they need more chances like that, don't they? Bitvest Wits have to find a way through this resolute defense. It's been a very, very even encounter. An encounter that's been largely devoid of a goal-mouther action. Both sides have had one shot on target. That's all. What counts is that Atletico de Madrid have got theirs into the back of the net. Atletico Madrid far more potent down the left-hand side, of course, because that's where Andy is operating. My, oh my, what a talent he is. In terms of substitutes, winger Ruben might be a good one, whilst for Bitvest Wits, young 15-year-old Ethan Andrews is a real possibility.
A good day for Bitvest Wits as they play in the final for the very first time. But not only that, one of their players has made history. Phakamani Mahlambi, the striker for Bitvest Wits first team, listed in the 2016 World Soccer Magazine as 500 most important players on the planet. Not just in the world, not just in South Africa, but on the planet, with the likes of Ronaldo, with the likes of Messi. Phakamani, how do you feel about this achievement?
I feel so excited about this, to be the same shit with the players that I look up to, so I'm so happy. I don't know how to explain, but I'm very happy.
Well, at only 18 years, you've already achieved that. That's amazing. But let's talk about your personal ambitions as a player. Where would you like to be?
Yeah, I want to see myself playing in Europe, but for now, I'm focusing on my injury. Then after my injury, then I'll come back, carry on working hard, then I'll get the opportunity to play where I want to play.
Today you are here as a spectator, but in 2014 you played in this very tournament. How has the tournament helped you and your career?
Yeah, it helped me a lot with gaining experience and all those stuff, playing against the team from abroad while I was still young, and now I'm able to cope with the other situation in PSL. So I can say the experience that I get from this tournament was very good, and it helped me a lot.
Well done for your achievement, and uphole bab.
Thank you, I'll be okay.
Phakamani Mahlambi, who has done so much, he has personified so much when it comes to the development of football in South Africa. Such a huge achievement. But don't forget that the action continues right here on your World of Champions. It is the final. Atletico Madrid hosting Bitvest Wits.
Welcome back to the Nike Center, where Atletico de Madrid lead Bidvest Wits by 1-0. The Clever Boys have it all to do in the second half of this final of Future Champs Gauteng. The game is back underway. What can the young men from Johannesburg do in order to claim this trophy, claim the bragging rights, and also stake their claim in the history books as the first ever local team to come away with top honors?
They have it all to do against the likes of Fede. And here's a warrior. They're going to need a warrior's fighting spirit. As you see, the teams on show today, the likes of Gomez and Gasco. Names like Andy stand out for you. They did well in the first half. Away back, Grant.
Both teams as yet unchanged. So for the moment, Dylan Shepherd just deciding that the men out on the park are the ones that will be able to do it for him. There's good substitutes available to him, though. Now Atto. He loses out, but it is a throw-in for Roy Blancos. Fede to Atto. Neat feet. Still alive here. Comes out almost as far as Andy. Now Dotiro battling away with Montero.
Good hustling from Dotiro there, Grant. He's busting a cut there.
The chance. Oscar to Andy. The ball's run away from him. Angle too tight to shoot now, but delivers it in. Oscar darting in at the near post. Keeper Daniel Mayer, quick enough.
We're speaking of a at the break, the possibilities of a penalty shootout. Should Tivitz be able to get themselves back in this game? A sort of mental state. Are these two teams, and we will be privy to their come penalty shootouts if it does happen indeed. That's for Athletic Madrid with one hand on the trophy.
If that were to happen, we might see the keeper from Jinguara in Brazil making his first save of the game, his first real save in the truest sense of the word. I mean, how can you go through an entire tournament without ever really being tested? Well, lapse in concentration there, perhaps a little slip. That's always a possibility. You run the risk of losing concentration slightly when you have so very little to do. Great skill by Yakin.
There's that man, Yakin Grant, the number nine. The goal scorer, 2-2 for him, the difference maker. You mentioned earlier something very interesting about strikers in Athletic Madrid. I'll take you back. They have this innate talent of finding world-class strikers, the likes of Fernando Torres, the likes of Aguero, and of course Costa, the most recent.
Absolutely right. And the giant sums of money that they get for those players when they eventually move on to bigger clubs, although none come much bigger than Atletico Madrid, really.
Unless you're Real Madrid.
Yeah, well, that is their one famous rival. They are the third most successful Spanish team ever. And that's across all competitions. In terms of La Liga, the Spanish top flight, they are the fourth most successful team behind Real Madrid, Barcelona, Athletic Bilbao.
That's an impressive stat indeed, given the vast sums of money the likes of Barcelona and Real Madrid tend to enjoy over various transfer windows. Impressive stuff. The structures are working there.
Well, of course, on their books at under 17 level, they do have the likes of Fede and Carlos from Equatorial Guinea and Cuba, respectively. Also, a young Colombian striker who's not with us at this tournament, as well as another front man from Guinea. So, They do look across the globe in order to find players, but one trend is that many of their players are homegrown right from Madrid, not even Spain, from Madrid itself.
Hence, they're able to employ a certain ethos, a certain philosophy that the players can only understand if from that area, from that region, as well as a sense of pride playing for the shirt. I think that's what Diego Simeone has done so well, playing for the shirt of the red and white of the man from Atletico Madrid.
Well, Andy from Alicante and Oscar from Tenerife were standing over this one. Interesting from the left foot of Andy, trying to catch out Daniel Mayer.
God, this boy is a superstar in the making. I mean, look at this. Fair to thought yet. Taking him away from the danger area. Says no, signore. Comes back and powers past him and powers a shot past Alex. Finally, some work for him.
Might I mention that he's coming up against Fede and has left him for dead. Alex called upon, can't answer the call. 6 goals for Shungo Dotero. The 17-year-old has made his mark on this competition, and just as they did against Torino, Bidvest Bits are right back in this.
For me, Grant, that man Shungo Dotero with that 6th goal, his level now with Ntuli of Downs in terms of the goal scoring charts. For me, he's been an outstanding player. Perhaps if it's win, man of the tournament, big shot from his side, or Andy from Athletic Madrid is another. Man in red and white. But wow, Alex though would be a bit disappointed with letting the ball in his near post. Should have done better.
Phillips. Dotero is interested. Just puts this back into the defender. It's judged to have been illegal by Givim Abasa, the referee. Fede keeps going. And he's fed once again by Atto, coming across in a hurry. Givmore Kupe perhaps making up for some of his mistakes in the first half.
Grant, you mentioned about that scouting network, that ability to find that striker who can win your games. I think Vets as well have been able to do well as that man there wasn't paying attention. Was Kanye. I'll get back to that point.
Dotero, chance to win it. Well, not to win it, but a chance certainly to go ahead. And he scuffs it. What a ball through. You're mentioning that well, Kanye was momentarily unaware of the fact that the ball was right upon him. He came to his senses, and then it was played through to the young number 9.
Oh, impressive, just to brush aside the bigger man in Montero. Dylan Shepherd looking on. I don't know what the scouting network has been quite good in identifying strikers of late. The likes of Keane. I think they found another little gem in Dotero Shungo. I think that was the first time I've seen him snatch at a shot in this tournament. Most of the time, ever so calm and tends to side foot a ball past a helpless goalkeeper.
Shungo Dotero turned 17 earlier this year. As Atto battles away and keeps going. Fede. Atto. Slip through. Yakin tries to cut it back to Oscar.
Chad Mayer take a bow, because if he had not blocked that ball, got something on it, Oscar was lurking. And Athletic Madrid were nearly in for their second. Great reverse ball by the man Salvador.
Second corner of the game for Roy Blancos. Whipped in at the back post was Montero. Perhaps surprised that it had come all the way to him. Now Rodri unleashes a shot. Daniel Mayer handles easily. Rowan Sidney would have expected to control a little bit better.
Another player has been impressive, that man in short, Chad van Heerden, the center back for the Clever Boys. Such a good defender. Do well to work with the likes of Bongani Khumalo. As Ethan Andrews makes his way onto the pitch.
Makes his way on for a limping September. 16-year-old from PE withdrawn, perhaps because of an injury. Now to Tiro with great strength against Carlos. Could have chosen to go down and win the foul there. Was brave and fair. Switch across field. Andy reels this one in. Then the cross to the back post. Coupe will watch it all the way over his head. Has to play it out towards Mudaberi, but Atto comes away with it. Luque. Now Gasco. Still Gasco. Eventually cleared away by Andrews. He'll chase his own clearance. And then adjudged to have committed the foul.
Grant, another very impressive thing from the man from Athletic Madrid. How often they look to play a forward pass. You saw Gasco, they looked like nothing was on, but he still tried to toe poke it in for Andy. Always looking to be on the front foot. Other man from Spain.
Here's Andy. And Yakin shot. Great save. My oh my. Possibly the save of the tournament from Daniel Mayer. That's a beauty.
Off camera there, Kanye having a word with Keenan Phillips, saying, come on, get in the game. What a save there, Daniel Mayer.
What a vicious shot from Yakin. Has had more chances in this game than in the first three that he participated in. Corner comes in. Mayer came for it and didn't collect. Had to be hacked clear by Spoot Lamini. Rodri just been ushered backwards slightly by the referee. Seems to be a problem for Daniel Mayer. Just made a beautiful save moments before this. That's great. I mean, that shot came at him with such pace and turned it over the bar. That's the one that leaves your wrists almost in agony.
That's the wrist crack up. Impressive as well to see how he saved those cat-like reflexes and he got up straight away. Dylan Shepherd there in shot. We'll be happy with his team's fighting spirit. They've continued to show this fighting spirit, Grant, in this tournament as Daniel Mayer. Not quite sure what was wrong there.
Seemed to be a problem with his gloves. Maybe believing that he wasn't getting the right kind of traction, still looking at them.
Perhaps something to your dance moves. You never know exactly what is going on there.
A bit of spit for the gloves, it should do the trick. Hopefully there'll be no issue as the game wears on. 15 minutes remain. 15 minutes for one of these sides to come up with a winner. Dlamini almost leaves the ball behind. Gas goes upon him quickly. Dlamini has to show a lot of strength. And the ball to Andrews. Still Andrews. Maybe doing a little bit too much. Eventually it's back to Dlamini. Dotero. I must say, I've noticed a couple of times that Rowan Sidney, he doesn't dive in. Here he is, hauled to the ground at the free kick. It goes the way of Atletico Madrid. So sometimes a man might go past a young Sidney, but at least he's not giving away unnecessary fouls, although he's been adjudged to have done so here.
I think you put the markers on him
there, can't understand why exactly. Montero out to Fede. Comes inside and crosses with his left to Yakin, who'd made a great run and just couldn't get onto the end of it.
Grant, the two strikers so similar in their movement, perhaps just Chungu Dutiro edging in the strength stakes. But wow, Yakin's movement in and around the box, it's like a fox in the box.
Well, he's had to develop such good movement because, of course, well, he can't rely on the physical attributes that Dutiro possesses. He's a short striker, but incredibly pacey is the young man from Wits. Oscar to Fede. Again with the left foot, deeming that to be more favorable, preferring to whip it in and curl it towards the back post.
I think there was another clear indication of Yakin's pace and ability, quick on the turn. The ball, unfortunately, was just over his head, but he was quick to turn around and see what else he can do from the chance.
Good header from Gasco. The Montero takes it beautifully out the air, but has given himself too much to do, and then goes flying into the back of Keenan Phillips. Dotero once again, the most impressive at this tournament. That's not impressive. Dotero, he goes down. Must be a red. Referee has another huge decision to make. What's he going to do? Clean through on goal. Goal scoring opportunity denied.
Well, that has to be a red card. He denied him a clear goal scoring opportunity.
Absolutely.
There. Give him a pass with another big, big decision. He went to yellow the last time. What color is the card this time around?
Well, he doesn't have a choice here, really. If he goes by the letter of the law, the rule book dictates this has to be a red card. Give him a Barca. We await your decision. Clearly takes him out. Reckless.
It's nowhere close to the ball there, Grant. Took everything but ball. He didn't get any of Shungu there. I think Shungu was in with an opportunity. Judging by the player's reaction, it is a red card, Grant.
Oh, yeah.
The seat in his right hand.
Alex is saying, please, please don't do this to me. He's sent off in the final. Atletico Madrid go down to 10 men. So who will be sacrificed now to allow Cesar to come onto the field and replace him?
I think the young man from Iguara cannot complain about that decision there from referee, given Mabasa.
He really can't.
But mind you, coach Armando De La Morino could come back and say, ref, why didn't you give Kanye a red card? Yet you gave my player a red card.
You would imagine that is what he will point to at the end of the game. Well, Alex can shake his head all he wants. So can De La Moreno, but really, the referee was left with no choice but to send him off of the field. It means that Bidvest Wits now will play the remaining 10 minutes of this game against 10 men. It's unfortunate that Luque has to be sacrificed. There's nothing else for it. Atletico Madrid are in deep, deep trouble now.
An interesting little moment I picked up there. The man who's just been sent off. The man from Rigueret, Alex. A long embrace with the man to replace him, Soto. Perhaps to say, please save me. And I just messed up there. Nonetheless, there is Soto, Grant.
Yeah. 17-year-old. Goes by the footballing name Cesar. Joined the club in 2015. Now, will Bidvest Wits go direct at goal? Look to test the new keeper early.
We've mentioned earlier that there have been very few moments in this tournament that we've seen, if at all, if memory serves me correctly, from a direct shot from a free kick going in.
Well, they haven't been. Modaberi looks to test the keeper. And Cesar gets hands behind it. Now, 3 weeks ago to the day, we were here at Nike Center to watch the final offering of the multi-choice Disky Challenge in what was effectively a final between Golden Arrows and Free State Stars. It was Golden Arrows who went down to 10 men and still managed to win on that day. Could Roy Blancos repeat those heroics against Bidvest Wits?
I'm more interested to see if Armando de la Morena, the Spanish mentor, what sort of game plan is he going to employ now? Does he keep it tight with about 8 minutes remaining? Or does he do what naturally comes to them? Be on the front foot and attack with 10 men.
Obviously a real opportunity now against the 10 of Madrid to go in search of that goal that would win them the final outright without the need for a penalty shootout. Penalties, of course, a real lottery for Madrid. They may just have to hope that they can make it to the shootout, and by all accounts it looks like they are going to try and run down the clock in search of a penalty shootout, as Cesar took that on his chest and then waited until Dotiro came upon him before actually collecting it. Yakin, what a story it would be if they could get a goal here. Yakin goes down to the area, squares up with Spoot Lamini. Oscar calling for the card. You can get yourself a card by doing that.
Grant Yakin is a fiery character. Doesn't like being tackled much, does he? He's a diminutive number nine. Saw similar scenes yesterday, him demonstrating so often.
Lamini picks up a yellow card. It's exactly what Oscar wanted. It's a very Spanish trend, isn't it? It's from referees. And Oscar still having words. Now, what has happened here?
Somebody's gone down there. Keenan Phillips, by the looks of it.
Montero will try and pull him up. If you remember yesterday, Montero was kicked in the box. And then when the Pirates player tried to drag him to his feet, didn't take kindly to it. He's trying to do exactly the same thing that he took umbrage with yesterday. Now, what exactly has transpired? You would assume someone has trod on his foot whilst the referee had his back turned. This is getting nasty.
Grant, I looked at the linesman on the far side to see if he had to put his flag up if he spotted anything. Kept it down throughout the holdout. All that fuckers there in the box.
Oh, Montero immediately telling Phillips to get up. As Yakin seemed to back into him, he didn't notice anything deliberate. It wasn't like he raised his foot and lashed out at him. Or
even this is a dangerous position here for
it
Vince.
Is. Goes in, save by Daniel Mayer. He's had to be on top of his game, and this time denies Andy.
Clever little free kick from Andy. I think everybody was thinking he was going to curl it to the right corner.
What Gasco has done is he's taken up a position on the edge of the wall. Yakin can't believe it again. Here we go again.
It's Yakin again, Grant.
They're a fiery bunch, aren't they? Roy Blancos of Spain. Like to try and get under your skin.
I think he's channeling his inner Diego Costa there.
At the moment, they're doing themselves a bit of a disservice. They're getting so angry, they're taking their mind and their focus off of the game. Andy was flying in on Keenan Phillips. Andrews over the top. Dotiro had eyes on it, but Fede covered really well. Now Phillips having to contend once again with Yakin. Montero. It's not very well done. Edson Kamalo coming forward first. Real chance he's had to run in this half.
Grant, with so much or little time remaining, the crowds are not just the only people who are anticipating and seeing what's going to happen here.
Totiero. And it goes too far. They're not only people, is it animals as well, Timber?
Oh, could be possibly.
It's the dogs of Mexico.
Exactly, my friend.
Cholos Guentes de Caliente.
Cholos.
Watching on. Tijuana have an interest in the outcome of this game.
They've done well in their campaign. Fernando Mendoza looking on. Here's the coach, de Mendoza. All peace, sons, love and peace. The man from Mexico looking on. As much anticipation as us here in the commentary box and here at Nike Center, Grant. Do you smell a twist in this tail?
Oh, there's been enough twists already. Here could be one. Yakin. In it comes! Oscar! As we approach the 60th minute, Atletico de Madrid, the 10 men of Atletico de Madrid, go ahead via the boots of Oscar. Could that be the winner? Bidvespitz will have to throw everything forward now.
Oh, clever little flick on there. It's that man again, Yakin. Looks like when the fight gets tough, he ups his performance, does well to get a ball back. And my oh my, it's that man Oscar. Is he the difference maker? We've already seen one team win with 10 men, Torino earlier. Told you, is there a twist in this tail, Grant? There's something about Nike Center.
Great flick by Ato, and then great fighting from Yakin. They love it on the bench of Atletico Madrid. Oscar scored two in the first two games. He's added to that now. Dela Moreno will be happy if his team can hold on. What a story this would be. The seconds are ticking away. Roy Blancos lead. What can Bidvest-Wits do? They've come back once already. Now only a minute of regulation time remains for them to find another equalizer. Dotiro, could he be the man to do it?
A bit of perhaps time wasting. They can taste victory here. Is that man Andy who's down? Perhaps a bit of cramp. Where's the play acting? Bring out your Oscar scripts.
I can tell you another group of people that are going to be terribly pleased if this result stays as it is. Mojoli Primary School. Of course, the primary school affiliated with the team win a whole bunch of sporting equipment, as we see Torino watching on.
I think that's a team that's not going to be happy to see Athletic Madrid winning. Of course, they were the defending champions. As they give a wave there, going to be handing over the trophy definitely to somebody at this stage. Looks like it's going to Madrid Grant.
Eto played a huge and crucial role in the goal that may just have won Atletico Madrid this game. He will be replaced by Iker.
Grant, look how slowly Andy's making his way off the pitch. Wow, it's like speed walking almost. I don't know, walking backwards.
Andy also, he's withdrawn and will be replaced by Ruben. Must mention Eto making his way off the field on the opposite end, can barely walk. So the two wingers in the wars.
Wow, Andy, take your time, sir. It's like he's modeling almost.
Can imagine there'll be plenty of modeling done with the trophy. It's a nice shot for Instagram if they are to hold on to this lead and win the tournament. Fede launches it long.
Grant, funny enough, I just looked off. Andy, having walked off the pitch, walked way faster after getting off the pitch.
Atletico Madrid doing their best to waste time in any way that they possibly can. They'll be making another double substitution when the ball goes dead. What can Wits do? They are against 10 men. Andrews rather will chase this. It's a throw-in.
Grant Vesnes to throw everything at this Athletic Madrid team. Throw the kitchen sink, throw a spanner, and throw a plumber at it if you have to.
Well, Phillips has come up to launch a long throw into the box. It's not bad. Really, this could be amongst their last opportunities. Mouriberi will have to wait just a few moments. Oscar, the goal scorer, will be withdrawn.
Grant, I think this is where that experience of Armando de la Morena is coming to the fore. Knows that his side just have to hold on for another 3 minutes or so. So doing all the best that they can do to eke out more seconds.
Funnily enough, Yakin, the other goal scorer, will also be withdrawn from the field. Just winding down the clock. Oscar has to come off from all the way on the other side of the field. He's having a right go here at Chad van Heerden, 17-year-old centre-back from Bidvest Wits. He was signaling with his elbow. Was he saying, you elbowed me? Or was he saying, I'm going to elbow you?
Cheeky little smile there from Oscar.
Throw in for Wits. Mouriberi takes a run up. And then to Dlamini. Whips it in back post. And Ruben just watches it run out harmlessly.
I think there was a... wasn't such a good option there from that man. If you are going to whip it in the box, at least try to get it to a teammate. Didn't give any of his teammates anything to work with there. 1 minute, less than a minute remaining, Grant.
Less than a minute of additional time, although there was a stoppage within the additional time. Wait to see what the referee decides. Free kick here. Really, everybody needs to get into the box. No point keeping anyone back. If I'm not mistaken, it looks like Daniel Meyer is interested. How heartbreaking this would be for Dylan Shepherd. Young coach. He's done excellent work. Whipped in. Flicked on. And he was going for goal there, wasn't he? Muzi Kanyi, the 16-year-old. Doesn't get it right.
You see with the disappointment there on his face, I think. Grant, his train has come and gone now for Bidvis Wits.
Della Moreno signaling five, saying five has elapsed. Why has the whistle not blown?
I don't think, referee, given Mabasa's Spanish is all the best of levels.
Now Andrews to whip it in. Dotero. Touch almost letting him down. And then the pass let him down. Fede comes away with it. That could have been the last real opportunity for Bidvest Wits. Moraberi can do nothing more and slide that out for a throw-in.
The referee just had a look at his watch, I think. Atletic Madrid up. Just with that. There it is.
Goes over and grabs the ball. Does give him a basso and then blows his whistle. Atletico de Madrid are the winners. Fede was signaling. He's signaling to the school children who have supported them all the way throughout this competition. They are ecstatic, as are the players on the field. Some lie upon the ground as if they've lost. They cannot believe that with 10 men, they've managed to eke out this result, which means that the Spanish debutants, the first ever team from that country to participate in this competition, win in their debut participation. What a feeling that must be. My, oh my. Timber, your thoughts?
My, oh my, Grant. I think Armando de la Moreno masterminded this off the back of a solid defense. Hence, they haven't conceded too many goals. They conceded the first of the tournament in this one, but their ability to always outscore the opponents has been key.
Well, they outscored Bidvest Wits today. They did concede their first goal. It didn't matter. Atletico de Madrid take the title via a scoreline of 2-1. Well, Fede removes his shin guards and the young men who have been ball boys throughout this competition flood around the players, hoping to grab some kind of memento. Dylan Shepherd gathers his charges immediately, possibly to congratulate them, because really they fought ever so hard to come back from this goal that was scored very early on by Yakin.
Yakin Grant has been the difference maker in the last two games. As you said, started off slowly but eventually kicked into high gear. I think he's been the difference in the last two games in ensuring that this team really does lift this trophy.
And then a moment of absolute brilliance. Dotero, the standout striker at this competition, shows great strength and pace and then sneaks one in at the near post.
I think he was saying to Yakin, anything you can do, I can also do.
Alex may be at fault. And then here it was, the winner, Yakin, heavily involved, played it across for Oscar to get that one Madrid the trophy.
Oh, you see what it means to these young players. Well done, Athletic Madrid.
It's heartbreaking stuff for Bidvest Wits, but what a story for the Spaniards. This is how things shaped up. After only getting two shots and one on target in the first half, Atletico Madrid got far more in the second, and the possession stakes were clearly in their favor, despite the fact that they were down to 10 men for a part of the second half. They had more attacks than Bidvest Wits, whilst both teams utilized their right wing to very good effect. It's been an unbelievable tournament, hasn't it, Timber? Here are the final results. Mamelodi Sundowns taking 9th place. Maputo taking 11th. Torino grabbed 5th place in the competition, while Club Brugge, an emphatic 6-0 victory that booked them the 7th place finish. The celebrations continue for the team from Spain. They were fiery at times, but always effective. And a resolute defense was the platform on which they built this great result.
For the very first time, Atletico Madrid are the champions for 2016. The first time in the International Future Champions Gauteng tournament, and they walk away victorious. I am now joined by Coach Dylan Shepherd of Bidvest. Very close one, Coach. It was just a last-minute goal that took away the opportunity to be crowned the champions.
Yeah, it's one of those things, you know. I mean, Atletico Madrid, one of the biggest clubs in the world. So, you know, we've got to take a lot from this. I told the boys that this is such a great learning experience, especially for their development. And I'm very proud of them. They outperformed any expectations, and I'm just happy to be a part of something that's been good this week.
And now, Coach, we saw a bit of a change in the players and the game of play within the last 5 minutes of the game. Would you say it was frustration trying to get that equalising goal?
Yeah, you know, it's always frustrating, you know, especially at youth level when there's play acting and they start doing funny things on the field. It's not the sportsmanship is not great. But anyway, you know, those are things we've got to get used to, you know. Those are things we've got to learn from. Last 5 minutes we pushed for a goal, but it didn't come. And, you know, well done to them.
Well, you don't walk away as the losers. You've got the number two spot at the top of all the South African teams.
Yeah, I know, we've got to be happy from that, you know, results-wise. But it's not really about the results, you know. It's about how I've seen players get better and better as the tournament got on. And like I said, it's about their development, and they are very proud of them. Eh?
Thank you so much for your time, Coach, and well done on the number two spot.
Thank you very much.
Coach Dylan Shepherd of Bidvest saying it's more about the experience. But I am now joined by Daniel, you've done amazing work, you know, trying to, you know, make sure that you keep a clean sheet. But I guess it wasn't to be today.
Yeah, no, you know, I'd first like to thank the Almighty for letting me have this opportunity to play and to shine for Him. Yes, I mean, it's not easy, you know. You go as a goalkeeper, you go in there every game, you just want to try and do your best, you just want to try and keep the clean sheet. However, as a goalkeeper, you will get beaten at some point, you guys understand. So I guess I just tried to give my best today, but it wasn't meant to be for me to keep a clean sheet.
Well, you gave your best, but I guess a Spanish La Liga team, that is Atletico Madrid, were the better side today. But also, when that second goal came in, you know you're playing for the championship. What was going through your mind?
Well, first of all was time, how much time we had left. But through the past week, the boys came back when we were down. When I thought we were down and out, the boys came back. So we showed good character. I thought we could have shown it today. However, the Spanish La Liga team, Atletico Madrid, they were just too strong for us. They were up, organized, they prepared well. And I guess, yeah, that's just it.
And what has been your highlight of the tournament?
My highlight would be actually making it through to the final. You know, I don't think many of the fans and or sport lovers, soccer lovers, thought that Bidvest Wits would make it in the finals, especially a South African team, considering the big names of Atletico Mineiro, your club Tijuana from Mexico. So it was really a highlight, and it was really a good opportunity for me and for us at Bidvest Wits to compete in this final.
Appreciate your time, and well done making it this far.
Thank you.
Daniel Mayor of Bidvest Wits, who made it through to the final, goalkeeper who done very well to ensure that the clever boys keep a clean sheet. But the winners today are Atletico Madrid, who for the very first time crowned the international future champions. Gauteng, how does coach feel?
¿Cómo nos sentimos tras ganar este torneo?
Bien, estamos súper felices, muy contentos por el trabajo que ha hecho todo el equipo durante toda la semana que llevamos aquí en Sudáfrica. A los jugadores, al cuerpo técnico y también felicitar al rival porque ha sido un gran equipo, el equipo rival.
So we are so happy, really happy for win this tournament and only thank you for the organization, thank you for the rival, really good play, it's a really hard team, difficult team today, difficult match, and thank you to our players, all the staff, everybody.
And what exactly has your players learned from this international tournament?
Algo de international tournament. Repeat me, please.
What have the players learned in this international tournament?
Vale. Que hemos aprendido en un torneo internacional como este.
Bueno, hemos tenido la suerte de poder compartir otras culturas y otros chicos de otros lugares del mundo. Y la verdad es que es un bonito recuerdo y la verdad es que es muy bueno para todos este tipo de experiencias.
It's really good these tournaments because we learned many cultures, different cultures, Chinese, African, more Europe, different cultures. And this is good for guys, for the team, and we really like these tournaments, and with the cup is better.
You are the champions, well done.
Somos los campeones, bien hecho.
Muy bien, muchas gracias, thank you, of Sudáfrica, y muchas gracias por todo. Estamos muy contentos y sobre todo cómo nos habéis tratado en general toda la gente de Sudáfrica.
Thank you for Sudáfrica, thank you for all and for the because they no sé cómo se dice trato.
Champions.
Happy, only happy. Thank you for all.
One can see the happiness with all the Atletico Madrid people saying that and they are happy.
Yeah, we are very happy. It's a nice tournament. The other teams are very difficult. Nice play for them.
well done to Atletico Madrid for being crowned the champions, and everybody wants to come in and to ensure and celebrate and make sure that, of course, they are the champions today and very happy with it. But I will then also continue saying to you guys that you guys can also interact with us at SuperSport TV, hashtag SS of football, and do let us know what you guys think. How did you guys enjoy that final game? Well, you know, the action continues right here on your World of Champions.
MEC Faith Mazibuko, MEC for Sports, Arts, Culture and Recreation, will be amongst those to present the trophy. Muy, muy bueno, De La Moreno and co. Well done, guys. What an excellent tournament you've had, and very deserving of this trophy.
And to the best player, Sitiaskis, we are sorry. But nonetheless, you can be proud of your efforts here today.
Many famous faces that you would have picked up amongst those dignitaries that will present the trophy. None more so than Christian Carambeau of France.
Yeah? So you've been practicing that French accent? Impressive.
Well, impressive is the operative word when it comes to describing Atletico de Madrid.
Also have fun, and I'm sure as we are interacting with Soweto people, give me microphone. Yeah. I'm sure as we are interacting with Soweto people, you are also enjoying everything that they are doing. I'm sure as we are interacting with our residents here in Soweto, you'll go back home and tell them that you were there in Soweto, and it is fun in Soweto. We wish everyone a congratulations, and thank you very much.
We're going straight to the first item of the day. Let's give it our round of applause for the MEC, please.
Well, what a tournament it has been. And we're winding down here, moments away from our trophy presentation. Club Tijuana, third place team, Bidvest Bits of South Africa, have fallen at the final hurdle. They come second. And like a charging bull, the Spanish side were almost unstoppable at times. They have won in dramatic circumstances. Glenn Salmon giving us some condolences to to the young men who have fought so hard for Bidvest Wits. Keenan Phillips with his face in his hands, he's disappointed. These young men of Tier 1, they'll be disappointed as well.
They'll be disappointed at a very good campaign, granted, just fell short at the hands of this Wits team that just been beaten Athletic Madrid. You just see the level of the teams that finally first, second and third.
A team that will hardly have to be dismantled if they are to make it to next year's tournament. Very, very many young men, only 15 at the moment, part of this Cholowitz Guentes de Caliente of Mexico.
Grant the likes of Espinoza, number 15, still so young, age of 16. The man, Daniel Lopez, and Edgar Lopez. Future looks also bright for the Mexicans. You see Christian Carambu there in the back. They're waiting in anticipation. Other man from Madrid, beaming with smiles.
Well, perhaps when they brushed aside Ferroviario Maputo in the opening game, 3-0, three goals that they got in the first half, they would have thought this would be all too easy. It didn't prove to shape up like that. They had to fight very hard against Orlando Pirates and against Bidvest Wits of South Africa.
Kofi Sepula with food for thought for him, for his Sundowns Chargers. Oh, to go back to the
he's smiling though. Yeah, it's been a good exercise. All part of the football education of these young men, of course.
I think what is also going to be crucial to come out of this tournament for the likes of Sundowns as he gets an award for fair play. Nice little moment between those two former players. How often would you see that moment captured in time? Well, for Sundowns, I think it's going to be crucial that a lot of these youngsters take the step up to the MDC level.
Absolutely. Many of them we expect to see in the coming season. That will kick off in September. And a guard of honor for Bidvest Wits. That's a beautiful touch from Atletico Madrid. After all the fire on the field, they've put those differences aside. It's all part of the game. And now this is a wonderful, wonderful moment as the first place team usher in the silver medalists to claim their prize.
Can be proud of their campaign as well. Had a little quiet word with Dylan Shepherd just a few moments ago, and of course he was disappointed, but he can hold his head up high along with his young charges, the like of Karabo Modibedi, the man with the funky dreadlocks hairstyle there.
And there's what the winners will claim. It just eluded Bidvest Wits. And they would have thought that when their opponents went a man down, that they would have been in with a real shot. It wasn't to be. Dylan Shepherd has instilled an excellent philosophy into these young men. And it's all about the posterity of the senior team, looking forward to the future and making sure that it's a bright one for Bidvest Wits.
I was about to add exactly that, Grant, that seeing the likes of Wits, perhaps not as moneyed, if I can say that, like the likes of Sundowns and Chiefs, that they rely mostly on their youth programs, and my, in good health, good stock, Shungu Titiro, Kanyi, Kumalo, Dibedi, and Leia, to name a few names. Future looks bright for the clever boys.
Well, defeat in the final few minutes of a game is often a very bitter pill to swallow, and for Bidvest Wits, the second place trophy will hardly be any consolation, but they'll look back upon this tournament when the aches and pains have faded away, when the memories start to fade as well, and look back upon it favorably. They did well, and it's hard to celebrate after losing out in such fashion, but you have to credit them, and they should pat themselves on the back for such a gutsy performance. And they've shown they're more than capable of holding their own against the very best in the world.
The likes of Givma Coupe, the skipper, went up against the best at under 17 level. And they nearly almost did it. They were a goal away from taking things to penalty shootouts. Yes, today's referees as well get a bit of an accolade. Oh, the refereeing today was a bit questionable, I might say. But nonetheless, that is done and dusted. It's all about these young men from Madrid, Grant.
Well, they will be led by Montero, not by the captain, Alex. And I like that. He has been outstanding. The 17-year-old from Sevilla, who wears the 5 upon his back, the first to receive his medal. Possibly the standout player in this competition. He's part of a defense that only conceded one goal.
Yakir now smiles, although he wasn't to claim along with the overall trophy, that golden boot. Can be happy, he had such an integral part to play. And not only getting them from the semis to the final, but also clinching the final in the end for them, Grant. With an assist and a goal. To say to them, for favor.
Took a long time to get off the mark, took a long time to get warmed up in this competition. But once he did, he was almost too hot to handle at times.
I don't know, the Spanish haka there?
Or maybe the haka is the only way that you can intimidate a giant like the two that flank the Atletico de Madrid team now, as they prepare to receive their trophy, as they prepare to celebrate after a week in which they've not had to really endure any downs. It's been all ups for them. It's ended on a high.
Grant as well, let's give props to the province of Gauteng, the people of Soweto, Marcel Pimville. Well done for coming out in your numbers midweek as well as today to give a bit of that Kasi flavor.
Kasi flavor, and of course, brilliante, excelente performance from these Spanish boys, who now prepare to lift the trophy. They've been waiting all week for this moment, and here it comes. Atletico Madrid 2016 Future Champs Gauteng winners raise the trophy in celebration of a tournament in which they did not taste defeat once. In fact, it was only wins for these young men, and their Brazilian keeper is blocked by his teammates. What a performance, what a tournament.
Take a Barca, take Madrid, job well done. Gonna be an interesting one in 2017, God. Can't wait, they'll be a year older.